What's up everybody, Rishi here, and in this video we will learn how a customer searches for a keyword in Google. In the next few videos we will also learn about keyword research from a point of view of an affiliate, that is us, and from a search engine's point of view. When we learn about keyword research in this manner, the concepts become extremely clear to us, because as you know, keyword research is important because that's what will help our videos to get found when somebody makes a search in Google. So without wasting any more time, let's learn about keyword research from a customer's point of view. Let me assume that I have some problem. Let us say that I feel dizzy when I'm traveling in planes, which I do. And I am looking for a solution for that problem. So what do? I just come to Google and I type, I am feeling dizzy in planes. So at this stage, I don't know anything about what my disease is or why I am having this problem. I am just trying to seek some information about the problem that I am having, and I am looking for a solution for the same. And also note that I typed in an extremely long phrase. So I keep looking at the top of the search engine, whatever results are coming. Okay, I see here Meniere's disease. So perhaps I will just copy this to a notepad and okay, here is another one where somebody has, I think it's a blog post. So basically, I will keep researching more about this information. And perhaps, instead of now searching for a long-term phrase, once I identified what exactly my problem is, I might even come to Google and type, what does this disease mean? But remember that I am still in an information seeking phase. And once again, I go into a few websites until I clearly understand what problem I am having. So maybe somewhere I read that it could be vertigo as well. So I come here and I type vertigo and I read more about it. So now I feel that either I could have vertigo or I could have Meniere's disease, which means now I am ready to move from the information seeking stage to the next stage. That is, I want to know how I can, what sort of products are available to cure my disease. So far we have seen that I was in an information seeking phase for the problem of dizziness that I was having. And I was typing several long tail and short tail keyword phrases in Google, and I found a few websites which had the same exact same information that I wanted, and now I'm convinced that I am having a vertigo or Meniere's disease problem. Now I'm going to do searches for products that will help solve my problem of the diseases that I'm having. So first I come to Google and type vertigo curing products. At this stage, I don't know what is the product name or what product can exactly cure my problem. But I just want to read product reviews. Reviews of products that can help solve my problem. So I come here and I type in vertigo curing products. Okay, there are a few blog posts on how to treat vertigo naturally, home cure. Okay, I could see here one, immediately stop dizziness, best miracle product experience. Okay, instantly relieves. So now that I've found some product, what I'm going to do is I want to read more product reviews of this product, because I am not entirely convinced whether this product will solve my problem. I want to see what other customers are saying about it. Even searchers have become extremely smart these days. In fact, they want to read the product reviews on the affiliate's blog posts rather than go straight to the merchant and buy the product, because they don't trust the reviews which are given on the merchant page. So this is how a customer, or let us say a person searching in Google, moves from a stage of no knowledge to a state of knowledge, which means I had absolutely no clue about what sort of products are even available in the market to solve my problem. But at this stage, I came to know about a few products that can actually eradicate my problem. So I'm almost at the buying cycle. Not exactly at the buying cycle, because I am still researching for different products that can solve my problem. Let us assume that I have researched on at least 6 products that can solve my vertigo problem. And out of those 6 products, one product has got overall the best reviews from everybody. So I come into Google and I straight away type the name of the product. Let us assume that name of the product was exactly the product which we had seen in Offer Vault. Nauseam Plus. So I come into this website, I come into Google and I type exactly the name of the product, which means I have typed a buyer keyword. Earlier, I was typing information keywords in the very beginning, where I was looking a solution for the problem that I had. Then I reached a stage where I was looking for reviews of different products for my problem. And finally, I reached a stage where I exactly know which product I want to buy. So I type the name of the product. I come into the website just to see if everything looks very convincing. Okay, I'm convinced that I'm going to buy this product. Maybe I'll try to find if this product is available in Amazon also. Okay, Amazon has this. In this case, there are no reviews, but for the sake of example, let us say that all reviews were positive. Okay, the price is 59. Let me try this product out and see what happens. So I come in the very next day having all the information about this product with my credit card. And I just put the name again, or I straight away go to Amazon or the website and I buy it. So this is how a keyword research works from a customer's point of view. In the next video, we will learn how the keyword research cycle process of the customer is useful for us.